Dear students, welcome and thank you for tuning in to another Saxon Dynamics video with me, Dr. Loay Al-Zube. We are still talking about simple truss. Lecture we have introduced in the previous two videos what a simple truss is, and we talked about the steps in order to determine the forces in members of a simple truss using the method of joints. And in this video, we are going to present an example and solve it together to show how we are going to apply the steps to find the forces in members of a simple truss. And we're going to talk a little bit about the zero force members and what they are, and we'll present an example of them. This is the example that we're going to try to solve together. We have a truss system shown in the schematic in front of you, and we are given the loads as shown on the truss. So we have only one external load, that is the 450 pounds, acting to the left on the joint D, and also I have the support reaction at A and C. And if you can remember from the support reaction, this is a two-dimensional problem. So this is a roller, and then here we have a pin. We're going to talk about this in a bit, about how to identify and use and place these reactive forces. So what we want to do in this example is to find the forces in each member of the truss. So you have this member C, D, D, B, C, B, B, A, and B, and A, D. So we'd like to find the forces. So how are we going to solve this problem? Let's talk about the plan that we need to follow step by step. So first, we would like to check if there are any zero force members. And zero force members, we have two types. If you have two members that they are not on the same line, attached together in a pin, but they are not on the same line. So let's say I have this member here, and it is attached to another member like here. If these two members, they're not on the same line, they don't have 180 degrees together, and there is two of them, right? Two members. And we have this pin attaching these two members and no force on this joint. These two members, we call them zero force members, and we don't need them in our structure. Also, there's another condition. If you have three members, right, two of them are joined together in a pin aligned 180 degrees, and a third member that is not aligned with the two, it's with an angle, and we don't have forces acting on this joint, this member here, the third one, is a zero force member, so we can remove it. So in this example here, you can see that we have BC and BA, those are two members, and we BD, their third member. So two of them are on the same line, and the third is not aligned together with them, so they have an angle 90 degrees, and I don't have any forces on the joint B, which means that again, three members, two of them aligned and one is not, and we don't have any forces or support reactions on this joint. So this member is a zero force member. So all the forces here in the DB equal to zero. So FBD or FDP equal to zero. And that's because it's BD is a zero force member. So I don't need to do any analysis here. And then we would like to start our analysis by finding the other forces within the members. And we will start with point D, then point A. Our selection of these points is actually to simplify the analysis. Try to avoid as many unknowns as possible. So in this point, I have two unknowns, right? This joint. So I have this force, that force inside these two members, and I have a known force. I can solve two equations for two unknowns. This point here, I have only one force going up based on the support reactions. And at this point here, I'm going to call this a Y, and I have the CY and CX. So two unknowns, adding together with the other unknowns in these members, those are four, it's too much. So let's start with D first and then A, and then we'll move on to C. Remember, at point A, I also have to find these two forces. So the plan is going to starting with D, then pin A. Why for this problem we did not find the external reaction forces before solving the problem? We're going to talk about this later on, but the reason for that is that we have a lot of unknowns and we would like to be able to simplify the analysis. And D is doable here because I have two unknowns and one external force, so that can be done. But I promise I will go back to this and talk about this in the class and as well as in other problems. So let's start our plan in solving this problem. The first step is to draw a free body diagram of the joint. So let's start with selecting joint D. That's where we want to start with. So I will say at a joint D. That's the first thing to do, our analysis. So for this joint, we're going to create this free body diagram. As I told you before, we have 450-pound external force. That's the blue force. That's the joint, right? I am going to assume a force going out of the joint. We said if all the in our analysis, always assume the force is going out from the joint, so that it's tension, pulling, that's tension on the joint. And I'm going to call this F based on the direction of the member DA, right? That's your FDA. We have this triangle is equal sides, so which means that this is a 45 degrees angle. This is also 45. And if you have a line here, because this is parallel to this one, this is also 45, right? That's what, how did we get the 45 here? Also, I have another member FD and C. I'm going to assume a force going out inside the member. That's what I want to identify when we analyze, we do force analysis of members. I'm going to call it FDC. That's the force. Again, this is 45. That's 45. As I mentioned before, the member DB is a zero force member. So we don't have forces here. The reason why, three members, one, two, three, two of them are aligned, and the joint, and the third is not, but the joint has no external forces or support reactions or reactive forces. That's why this is, we don't have a force here. So as we assumed before, FDB equals to 0 pounds, right? It's good. We constructed the free body diagram of pin D. Now, I need to use the equation of equilibrium, construct the equations of equilibrium at point D. So forget everything else. We focus on the analysis of this joint. That's why it's called the method of joints. Now, you need to construct these two forces, FAD and FCD, need actually to be presented and in a Cartesian form. So if I wanted to resolve FAD, I will say this is 45, right, with the x-axis. So this is going to be FAD cosine 45, right? And I have another one going down to be FAD sine 45. Same goes for FCD. I'm going to have a force going this way on the x-axis. I'm going to call this, I'm going to call it FCD cosine 45, and I will have another one going down that's FCD sine 45. This way I have resolved all the two forces, this one and that one. Now you can construct your equations of equilibrium on the x-axis and the y-axis. So to do so, summation of forces on the x-axis, you have assuming that positive is going to the right on the x-axis, 450 going to the left, so that's minus 450, and then you have a positive FCD cosine 45, that's what you have here, and then you have another force going to the left, which is FAD cosine 45. All of these, we don't have any other forces on the x-axis, so it should equal to 0, that's your equation 1. Equation 2, on the y-axis, you have FAD sine 45 going negative, that's this one, and FCD sine 45, also negative, going down, that's this one, should equal to 0. To solve these equations, I will use number 2 here, and I will write, let's say, FCD in term of FAD. So I will say that FCD equals FAD, right? This should be negative, FAD sine 45, divided by sine 45. Right? So this is gone with this. So FCD equals minus FAD. Again, it's going to the other side, that's positive. You still have that negative, that's negative. And then you substitute in 1, right? This one, substitute in 1, and then you can find the values of FCD. And you will get FCD to be 318 pounds. It's positive, which means that our assumption going out of the joint is positive. So that's tension. Remember, whatever happened to the joint is actually happening to the member. So if I'm doing this tension, it means the member is also doing tension because I've isolated it. And so the member is in tension. The force is actually tension force. Once you have FCD, you can find that FAD, as we said, it's negative FCD. So that's minus 318 pound, and that's in compression. So the member is in compression, and the joint is feeling compression as well. So this concluded the analysis of the joint D. Now we need to move on to joint A, because in doing the force analysis for trusses, you need to go from one joint to another. For joint A, we need to recall that we have already FAD to be minus 318. You will keep it this way. And you come here at this joint, we have this reactive force going up. That's AY. It's this one. And I'm going to, as we mentioned before, always assume at the joint forces going out into the members for the member. So that is going to be FAD. And the other member is going to be FAB. So these are three forces. The angle here is 45, as we mentioned before. And now I have FAD is equal to minus 318. So how many unknowns do I have? I have 1 and 2 unknowns, right? So we can solve, we can construct two occasions of equilibrium and to solve for these two unknowns. To do so, we can do the analysis on the x-axis. So on the x-axis, I have FAB, right? That's FAB. And also I have 318 negative. That's because my force is negative. And this is cosine 45. Because if you do the resolve this, this is FAD cosine 45. And that is FAD cosine, 45. Once you have that, I can find FAB immediately, right? And once you have FAB, you can say actually also some assuming that positive going up on the y-axis, summation of forces on the y-axis equal to 0. So your FAD, right? Sine 45 plus AY equals to 0. You know what's FAD? That's minus 318. So you can find AY equals minus FAD, which is 318. That's positive at sine 45. And that's your AY in pounds. And that's positive actually. So that is tension as well. So this is probably showing you how to analyze each joint, and then we move to the other joint, to the C. So I want you to think about, could you have analyzed joint C instead of joint A? I would assume, I always, you know, advise my students to go with the joint with the least number of unknowns, especially for reactive forces. But we're going to solve a couple of problems where we are going to focus on identifying the reactive forces from the support reactions before analyzing the joints or the sections of our trusses. I hope that this example was helpful. Thank you for watching. Until the next video. Bye.